So now equation number 3 and equation number 4 are off. So here then we have A equals to x minus 1 by x is the equation number 3 and B is equals to y minus 1 by y is the equation number 4. So this is of equation number 2 and this is of equation number 4. So equation number 2 is of A is equals to x minus 1 by x. Then now equation number 2 is of A is equals to x minus 1 by x and 4 is of B is equals to y minus 1 by y. Then now, so here as per the problem, we have to prove that 1 plus AB plus A square B square plus A cube B cube plus dash dash up to infinity as xy by x plus y minus 1. So that is a condition to be proved. So here I want to take, so here LHS. So here as per the problem, LHS, the left hand side quantity is of, the given condition is of 1 plus AB plus A square B square plus A cube B cube plus dash dash consisting infinite number of terms in it. So here I want to assume this as, so here plus 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 in between each and every term. So I want to assume, so this as S of infinity, sum of infinity terms. So then S of infinity will be equals to 1 plus AB plus A square B square up to infinity. So here then we have S of infinity is equals to 1 plus AB plus A square B square plus A cube B cube plus dash dash up to infinity terms. Then now here T1, the first term is of 1, the second term is of AB, the third term is of A square B square and the fourth term is of A cube B cube. So here clearly we can write it as, so now T1, the first term is of A, generally represented by means of A, which is equals to 1. So from this it is clear that, so A is of 1. And now ratio, common ratio is given by means of T2 by T1 between the ratio of first two or this next two. So that is equals to consecutive terms. The ratio between the first two consecutive terms or the next two consecutive terms will give us the common ratio. So T2 by T1 is the common ratio, whereas T2 as per the problem it is of AB overall divided by T1 is of 1. So AB by 1 is equals to AB. So in this manner I got this R, the common ratio, as AB. So here in this manner I got A value as 1 and R value as AB. So here S of infinity, but we know that S of infinity is given by means of A divided by 1 minus R. Then now let us replace A value as 1 and R value as AB. So here put A is equals to 1 and R is equals to AB in the above equation or the above formula, which is S infinity equals to A by 1 minus R. So here then we have S of infinity is equals to A. So here A value is of 1 overall divided by 1 minus R. So here R is of AB. So then now next logical step will be of, so here we got the values of A and as well as B. So here A is of x minus 1 by x and B is of y minus 1 by y. So let us replace these two values. So in the 2 and 4 in the equation number 5. So let us suppose this as equation number 5. From 2, 4 and 5 equations, the next logical step will be of, from 2, 4 and 5 equations, that is, so second equation is of x equals to A is equals to x minus 1 by x. This is of second equation. and b is equals to y minus 1 by y is of fourth equation, and s infinity is equals to 1 by 1 minus ab. Say s infinity equals to 1 by 1 minus ab is of equation number 5. Then now s of infinity, so that implies s of infinity is equals to 1 divided by 1 minus a. So here a is of x minus 1 overall divided by x, x minus 1 overall divided by x into b. So here b is of y minus 1 overall divided by y. Then the next logical step will be of, so that implies s infinity is equals to 1 divided by, the LCM will be of x into y, xy. So there is no denominator here, we can write it as 1, or in other words xy ones are will be of xy. Directly we can write it as xy is the LCM, then xy into 1 is of xy minus xy, and xy will be gets cancelled. So only these two brackets are left over, that is x minus 1 into y minus 1. Then now, so this is the numerator and this will be the denominator, and again this will be the numerator, and this numerator come and multiply in the numerator place only. Or in other words, it is in the form of a overall divided by b by c. A, instead of division symbol, if I write it as into, b by c becomes c by b, it's reciprocal. So here xy will come in the numerator place. So here xy into 1 is of xy, the next logical step will be of xy into 1 is of xy overall divided by, this condition is same. Then now s infinity is equals to, so here xy overall divided by xy into 1 is of xy in the numerator, and this denominator will be same. So xy minus these two brackets, x minus 1 into y minus 1 will be same. Xy minus x minus 1 into y minus 1. Say here I have utilized, since a overall divided by b by c can be written as a, instead of this division symbol I wrote it as into, then b by c must be written as its reciprocal, that is c by b. So based upon this logical step, based upon this reason, I got this logical step. Then now, the next logical step will be of, so that implies s of infinity is equals to xy overall divided by xy minus, so here let us multiply, within this square brackets I want to multiply these two brackets. First of all, the second bracket completely must be multiplied with this x, the latter second bracket completely must be multiplied with this minus 1. So x into complete bracket y minus 1, then minus 1 into complete bracket, square bracket closed. Then now the next logical step will be of, that implies s of infinity is equals to xy overall divided by xy minus, now here bracket consisting two terms must be multiplied with x, so x into y and x into 1, 1 into y and then 1 into 1. Then now the next logical step will be of, x into y is of xy minus x ones is of x, then now minus 1 into y is of minus y, that is 1y. Minus of minus will be of plus, 1 1za is of 1, bracket close. Then now the next logical step will be of, that implies s of infinity is equals to xy overall divided by xy. So here this bracket is consisting minus sum, minus sign in front of the bracket. So here when we open the brackets, then the signs of, signs inside the term, signs inside will be changed. So here signs of the each term will be changed. So here, or in other words, minus into xy as minus xy, minus of minus is of plus, then minus of minus is of, minus of minus is of plus, then x must be written as it is. Then now next term, so minus into minus is of plus y, minus into plus is of minus 1. This xy and xy are of like terms, this xy is of negative, then xy is of positive, so yeah, these two can be gets cancelled. Then therefore sum of infinity is equals to xy overall divided by x is of positive and y is of positive, that is x plus y minus 1. But as per the problem, so here equals to xy divided by x plus y minus 1 is nothing but the right hand side. So in this manner I got, so here therefore LHS quantity is equals to the RHS quantity. Then now hence it is proved.